Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. Today I'm going to have a look at a filament from Extruder called Biofusion. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament has a pretty long description and I'm going to try to read out the label. So let's have a look. Here they say print settings should be 205 to 230 and I was printing at 220 degrees and bed temperature should be 20 to 90 and cooling 30%, so pretty much similar to PETG. I was setting this material up as best as I could based on that information. But here they say Biofusion is a new breed of excellent material, best suited for designers and makers who are looking for extra shiny appearance of the printed parts. Besides a good and special look, Biofusion is also stronger than standard PLA and PETG, and that's quite an interesting claim. So you can use it for mechanical parts. The temperature resistance of the material is up to 75 degrees. It's very easy to print, that doesn't require a heated bed or a closed build chamber. Not much experience is needed to get extraordinary results. I shine on, and more information on the website extruder.com. And made in Austria. But let's have a look at the prints. You can see some brake tests here. Here's the seal layer slot. That one came out excellent. Really good print results. It's really shiny and deep blue color, like a metallic blue color. No stringing or overhang issues to speak of. It looks really cool. I was quite hopeful this filament would turn out to be a great one. So I decided, because of the claim it says on the label it's stronger than PLA, I printed out some brake tests. Went to most of them, but not to show on camera. It's extremely brittle. It's the value I get on my brake test is like 4 to 5 kilograms, while PLA is 45 to 55, 5 times stronger, no, 10 times stronger in later season. And because I printed all the print tests, I ran out of filament on this Otis model by Gareth, but it was coming apart. It was really easy to break it. Later season is really bad. So the claim of being stronger than PLA is not what I was experiencing. I guess it's just marketing. At least I didn't get good layer adhesion. I was following the instructions best as I could. But that's sometimes what you get, high hopes and poor results. And that's quite fun to try out new stuff and see how it really is. It looks quite good. That like the patchy look and feel of it, and I guess it's just some version of patchy with some additives, but I don't know. It doesn't say anything about the material itself, but just claim it's better than PLA in strength, and that's not the case in my testing. But that will be it for this video. If I would have a more filament, I could do more testing, like a full review, but based on the sample I didn't have a chance to get better results. But if you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please subscribe and ring that bell and hit the like button and leave a comment. So this will be it for now. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next.